What's going on, filmmaker? Sasha Jordan-Apple here, and thank you for tuning in this week. I really appreciate everyone who subscribes. I say it all the time, but thank you. Let's get into it. Pooh! All right, so today I want to talk about ND filters, specifically the Polar Pro Peter McKinnon Variable ND Edition versus the classic Tiffin Variable ND filter. Now, I'm gonna do some comparisons here and we're gonna see kind of the pros and cons of each of them and which one I prefer for the types of work that I do. So first, let's talk about the Tiffin 77mm Variable ND. It costs about 125 US. Its highlights are 2 to 8 stops. Pretty much any lighting situation that will pretty much cover it for you. So the ring on the Tiffin Variable ND just keeps rotating. There's no stoppers, so it does cause a cross polarization depending on the lens you're using, so that's kind of a downside. It's made in the US, which is cool. Takes up some real estate on the end of the lens. It's kind of clunky looking and it's a little big. The actual rotation of the Variable ND is kind of loose feeling, and I've noticed over time it gets a little looser and looser and you have to tighten it up. And I've used this Variable ND for the past 5 years and I loved it. The only downside I would say about it is that cross polarization that you can get depending on the lens you're using, as well as there's no way to put a lens cap on it to stop dirt or dust from getting in. And if you do try to put your lens cap on it, depending on the lens you're using, it just kind of falls off or it pops off. It doesn't really stay there. And Tiffin doesn't provide you with any lens cover, so it's kind of a downer. I think they should come up with something. Okay, let's talk about the Variable ND filter by Polar Pro. The Peter McKinnon edition costs about $249.99 US, which is quite a bit more than that Tiffin, $125 US. They make two different versions. There's a 2 to 5 stop version and a 6 to 9 stop. I got the 2 to 5 stop version because I find in most situations that's all I really need, and if I need a little extra stop, I'll just stop the camera down to f4 or something like that. And the reason they did this and didn't just go from 2 to 8 stops like the Tiffin is because they want to avoid that polarization that you get when you're trying to cover that much ground. Like the Tiffin Variable ND, when you're trying to cover that many stops, so Polar Pro has basically split it up into two different Variable NDs, which kind of sucks, but at the same time, I understand why they did it. Something else they offer on the Peter McKinnon edition here is it has these actual stoppers. It won't just keep rotating, it actually stops and starts, so you know where you're at on your Variable ND, and it also prevents you from getting that polarization look, which is pretty cool. Boasts zero vignetting down to a 16mm focal length, which is pretty cool. It's made of fused quartz glass, which they say is the best on the market. Comes with this amazing Defender Slim cover, they call it. And I love this thing because it just pops on top of the ND and it covers your glass. It also acts as a way to take off your ND without getting fingerprints on it, which is super smart. It's very cool. Very helpful and very useful. So a big difference between the Tiffin ND and the Polar Pro ND is that the Polar Pro ND is very slim and it takes up barely any real estate at the end of your lens, which is really cool. A little side note here I want to mention, which was important for ND filters or any filters in general. There was a company called Alter, and they made an Alter filter system for the front of lenses, and it basically acted as a way to go from no filter to any type of filter, and it works on a hinge basis, and I'll show you right now. It works really well. Unfortunately for Alter, they just went out of business. I'm not sure if it was because of COVID-19, but it's really sad because I really liked the product, and they were coming out with another product where it had a built-in lens cap on it that folded down, and I was really sad to hear that they're out of business. This Alter product worked so well with the Peter McKinnon Polar Pro Variable ND Edition. Both of those combined, you're able to use the Defender Slim cover right on top of it, and it just works great, and I'm super excited that I bought the Alter system before they went out of business. So I have two of them, and I'm gonna have two Polar Pro Peter McKinnon Edition Variable ND filters for both my cameras, so I'll be able to just flip that ND up and down as needed, depending on if I need ND in a situation or if I don't need ND in a situation. So super happy I got that. Kind of a final thought here is I love when a product delivers what it promises. I was always very kind of disappointed with all the Variable ND filters out there because they never really did exactly what I wanted. They always had that polarization problem. They always felt clunky. They never had a way to put a lens cap on. And I know that there was companies out there making magnetic lens caps, but that's just something that I never really wanted to buy into because it only had one use, just basically put the magnetic lens cap on, and then that's it. My point here is that with the Polar Pro Peter McKinnon Variable ND Edition, it really is high quality. It feels right on the lens. It takes up very little real estate at the end of the lens. It does exactly what it says it's supposed to do. There's no polarization. There's no vignetting. It just works. And that little defender cap they came up with is just genius for putting your ND on and off of your lens. I love that, and I'm gonna use it all the time. I'm probably gonna retire these Canon lens caps, just get rid of them. I love it, and I'm a big fan of it, and I'm looking forward to buying more of Polar Pro's products. These are ideas that are very practical for filmmakers that are actually working in the field. A lot of ideas, they don't seem like they're tested in the filmmaking field, and it's like, were they even thinking of the filmmakers when they came up with this product? And with this Variable ND that Polar Pro and Peter McKinnon came up with, they really thought about the actual filmmaker in the field and the types of situations we run into, and I think that's a big win for them as a company. All right, guys, that's today's vlog. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for leaving likes. Thanks for commenting. I always love getting back to you guys. If you haven't subscribed yet, consider it, and I'll see you guys next week. Peace.